A very warm welcome to this course on Probability Foundations for Electrical Engineers. Now, many of you might have probably heard of probability, might have already learnt probability before, and I'm sure you agree that probability is used for modeling so many things in life. Okay, all around us, we see so many things are random, and it's good to know probability. But this course is specifically targeted at electrical engineers, and you might wonder why in electrical engineering probability is important. Now, I would like to give you a few examples in the area of electrical engineering where probability plays a very important role. The first case is when you want to model noise in systems. Now, many circuitry and circuit elements have noise in them. If you want to communicate information from one point to another, you have to face noise. Now, noise is a complicated phenomenon occurring because of various physical factors. Now, it's not possible to write down exact equations for all those physical factors, and we give up and model it in a probabilistic manner. And that probabilistic model has been extremely successful. You see circuits all around you, you know, integrated chips and all that, that are functioning in spite of noise in a very wonderful manner, and that's because we really understand how noise works. And you see so many communication systems around us communicating in the presence of noise without any errors, and that's once again because we understand the probabilistic noise model very, very well. Noise is not the only thing that is modeled using probability in electrical engineering. One more important area is let's say communications networking, okay, or even signal processing. Okay. Quite often, phenomenon in a computer network is probabilistic. So, if you imagine a cell phone network, okay, not just necessarily a computer network, any communications network for that matter, a cellular phone network, if you want to say deploy a cellular phone network, you have a certain fixed bandwidth and you want to serve as many mobile phones as possible. And while so many people have mobile phones, not everybody is talking at the same time. Once in a while, you pick up the phone, turn it on and want to talk. And even when you are talking, you may not be talking continuously for a long time. You maybe talk for 1 minute, maybe talk for 3 minutes, maybe talk for 2 minutes, etcetera, etcetera. So now, you have a situation where you have so many users whom you want to connect in a communication network, and you don't know who is going to be on at what time, how long are they going to turn on, how do you connect, how do you give them resources like bandwidth and time, etcetera. All of that is also random. And when you deploy communications networks like that, you have to have a very good understanding of the randomness in that phenomenon and be able to model it probabilistically and use it in your system deployment. Otherwise, you will be wasting a lot of bandwidth. Bandwidth, as you know, is very, very expensive. Now, similar situations arise in signal processing. So, today, speech recognition is considered a very important problem. And speech, the speech signal, is essentially random. When you want to build a speech recognition system, you have to imagine that the speech signal coming at you is random in some sense. And you have to model it probabilistically, and you have to build devices which can understand that model and use that model and ultimately recognize what is being spoken, etcetera, etcetera. So, hopefully I've convinced you that there are enough applications in the area of electrical engineering for probabilistic models, and probabilistic models play a vital role today in so many aspects of systems that we see everywhere. Okay. Now, a few words about this course in particular. This course is titled Probability Foundations. So, we are not going to be doing so much applied probability. While I gave you some examples of systems, we will never talk about systems in this course. It's more about the basics of probability, built from the ground up, from the basic axioms, basic definitions. We will use very simple experiments like tossing a coin, throwing a die, picking a card from a pack of cards, throwing balls into bins, things like that. Very simple experiments to clearly bring out the fundamental foundational concepts that are needed for understanding larger systems. Okay, so, this is an introductory course, a first course in probability, and the idea is to teach you the foundations so that you can take more advanced courses going forward in the future. Okay. Now, what kind of prerequisites do you need? You will need basic calculus, a good foundation in basic calculus. You should know the real number system, you should know the number system, you should know what are functions, you should know things like continuity, differentiation, integration, particularly multivariable integration. Even two variable integration is very, very useful in this course. All these things we will assume you know. One particular function that will play a very important role is the exponential function, and you should know a little bit about that, and its counterpart, the logarithm function, also is something that you should know very well. And other areas of mathematics, it's good to have a general competence in mathematics. For instance, set theory you should be comfortable with, and basic summing of sequences, all of those things you should know. Okay, that's about prerequisites. And the course is structured in an easy manner. We are introducing the concepts over 8 weeks. There will be enough examples. There will be a lot of problems. Assignments are extremely important in probability. You really learn probability only by solving problems. I hope you have a enjoyable time in the rest of the 8 weeks of the course. And together with Professor Aravind, who is one of the main lecturers in the course, my name is Andrew Thangaraj. Both of us will be handling this course for you. I hope you have a wonderful time. Thank you very much.